Hey guys, what's going on? Today we're going to be talking about the new LR character that's coming on top of the new events that are going to be coming out on Dokkan Battle Global side. We also have a little bit of JP news, so let's go ahead and just talk about it real quick. JP side World Tournament has been suspended temporarily due to connectivity issues. We don't know what's going on with it. This was posted about 5 hours ago, so anything that has changed, I'm not up to date with, but it is currently suspended as of my knowledge. So with that being said, let's go ahead and jump into the global news. As you all are probably aware, the LR Vegito card has been announced in-game. We've been waiting for this since about July. He was part of the LR election, along with another merged Zamasu. So that was one of the options that we could have chosen for our cards if you wanted to. Now, there's no guarantee that there's going to be an LR, you know, merged Zamasu coming out at any time soon. That we did have the Rosé and the Zamasu cards together, but we may actually get a merged Zamasu card due to the fact that we have a leader over here, due to this leader anyway. The other option could probably be another Rosé and LR Rosé. Well, we'll have to wait and see and find out what's going on. Either way, we do have new information about the LR Vegito. We only have actual information about the SSR and TUR variants, so we're going to go ahead and talk about that. So first off, shout out to the Reddit, because Reddit has posted up all this information. And the Vitara medals and all this other information about what's going on, and shout out to dbz.space for other information. So we're going to go ahead and talk about it. First off, we're going to start off on the Reddit global database update. Let's go ahead and zoom in a little bit so it looks a little bit better on here. So I've been messing around with my OBS, and I've been having some troubles with, like, getting it on Windows 10, and I'm trying really hard. I'm going to have to look for a new program to use, just because it's not that great. Okay, so we have new cards: Super Saiyan 3 Gotenks, Super Saiyan Dokkan, So we have new cards: Super Saiyan 3 Gotenks, the Super Saiyan Gotenks that Dokkan's from the Agility one, the Strength Gotenks base form, Dokkan Awakens from his other base form, Kaba, Hit, Super Saiyan or SSR, STR Vegito, and TUR. We don't have his LR yet. Upcoming events: LR Vegito Blue announced, confirmed to be a new SSR, seems to be free. It is free from Baba Shop and obtained by trading Supreme Kai Stones, which is available from the Baba Shop. New items: Vitara Metal used to Dokkan the SSR Vegito, that's going to be available from the Baba Shop. And new missions. New missions coming 12/15 for that reward Supreme Kai Stone, so stay tuned for that. Goku Jr. event returning on 12/1, so if you guys haven't done the Goku Jr., I plan on getting the base form Goku Jr. that I have up, maxed out with the orb system when that comes available. And then new event mission starting on 12/9, completing orb events. Looks like all 5 are going to be daily, unconfirmed though. And Turtle School training gives stones? Interesting. Orb event is daily, stones, Turtle Stool is not. So, awesome. That's actually really cool. Orb event is daily stones. So, alright, cool. First off, next up, we have the actual phrases that they use. My favorite 2 are the Super Saiyan 3 Gotenks, Time to Stir Up Some Trouble, and Anyone Order a Beating. Those are really my favorite ones. But, yeah, outside of that, we're going to talk about the SSR Strength Vegito. We're actually going to go over and jump onto the dbz.space for it. So here's the LR character. This is what was announced in game. If you haven't already checked it out, this is what you're going to see inside the actual game. So that's pretty awesome. This just tells you event coming soon, but you know, we go over here to the release schedule, and we have the information that is going to be released on 12/14 at 10:30 p.m. So that's Sunday night, Monday morning, depending on where you are in the globe. That's when this event's going to become available for you, or at least the actual card. So what I'm going to recommend to you guys is to grind your butt off this weekend to go and get those Supreme Kai medals if you haven't already done so. If you already used all of them, and like me, the first round, I used everything on stamina. I have not utilized anything else from the second round because I haven't grinded them out. So that's what I'll be doing this weekend. I'll probably end up making a video or two about it, about what teams to build and everything like that to go up against, because I had some requests about it. But yeah, I will be doing that. So if you want to check that out, make sure to subscribe if you're new, so that way you can get that information when it becomes available. Anyway, we also now, well, let's talk about the Vegito card real quick, because I know everyone's hyped about that. We have this leader skill, super type, key +2, HP, attack, and defense +30%. When he Dokkan Awakens, that leader ability becomes +40%, super type, key +2, HP, attack, and defense +40%. Now, I don't know what they're going to do here. I don't know, we obviously don't have the LR information, but they might make it leader skill, super type key plus 3, HP attack and defense plus 70%, or they could just do the 50%. They could literally make his leader ability the spitting image of the other Vegito Blue. No one knows what's going to happen. We don't know how, if this guy's going to be OP or not. We don't know if his like Vegito Blue form is going to be able to counter. We'll have to wait and find out. There's no speculation on my end on what's actually going to happen here. So we're going to have to wait and see, and hopefully this works out to be in our favor. His super attack, though, on his TR form raises attack and defense and causes supreme damage to the enemy, which is cool. And his passive skill, Overflowing Fusion Power, attack and defense plus 60%, raises ki up to 8, based off of the amount of ki you have or health you have remaining. The more health you have lost, the greater the ki boost. So it's really interesting. We're not going to really go into his link skills or anything like that. Overall, not bad unit. Looks like with max orbs on this guy, he's going to have 14,000 attack and 12,000 HP. So his LR form is going to be pretty OP. I would recommend, honestly, guys, he is farmable. Base form Vegitos are farmable. It's not going to be for a couple more months on our end. It's up to you. If you really want to run him, if you don't have any good leaders or you don't have any good units and you need the LR variant of him, you can do it, because you could always reverse doken him to get him up to super attack 20 if you want to. Or super attack 10 technically. But I would recommend waiting for the Super Vegito event that you can grind out the base form Vegitos and feed it into him. Because at that point, then you don't have to waste Elder Kai's. If you don't care about wasting Elder Kai's, I mean, heck, go for it. Go more power to you. Me, myself, I'm probably going to just Z-Awaken him, get all 4 Dupaz unlocked if I can do so. And once all 4 Dupaz are unlocked, I'm just going to wait for that Vegito event to come out. And once it comes out, I'll grind him up to Super Attack 10. Outside of that, yeah, we'll have to wait and see what happens. But yeah, it looks like he's going to be a solid unit. It looks like he's a little bit underwhelming so far based off of what we all hyped him up to be. But we don't know what's going to happen from TUR to LR. So until that happens, I cannot give you a full opinion. All I can say is that his TUR form would be a B tier for me at this point. Like, he would be one of those units where it's like, I have my OP tier that I would always run. Then I would have my A tier that would be good substitutions. He may come into like a low A, high B, just because it doesn't look like he's going to be doing a lot of damage at all. It really, he doesn't look that great or that amazing based off of his stats right now and abilities. But maybe, who knows, the LR variant might come in handy. Who knows, maybe it's going to be like key plus 12 based off of the HP that you have left. So that way he's guaranteed to get a super attack. And his super ability could be key plus 2. HP attack and defense plus 70%, or key plus 1 HP attack and defense plus 70%, or 90%, or something like that. Who knows? Key plus 2, but we'll see what happens. But yeah, and maybe it can greatly raise his attack and defense, causing supreme damage, or colossal, obviously. But we'll have to wait and see again. So I'm not going to go too much more into it. I will do a full review of the information when we get the LR information out there. So again, if you're new and you want to get that information when it comes out, just make sure to subscribe. Now we're going to go into the less hyped characters, I guess everyone's going to say. We have the Hit and the Kaba that are going to be available. They are mono strength team support units. Hit being the extreme support and Kaba being the super support. Honestly, again, I've said this multiple times to you guys in the past. If you do not plan on running mono teams in the future, if you plan on going with categories, they may not be worth it for you. The banner typically comes out with a double Elder Kai drop, and it will come out with an LR usually. So like LR Broly, the SSR variant should be available in that banner. So, you know, you want to try your luck and you want to do the Super Saiyan 4 team or the Janemba team, then this would definitely be the banner for you. If not, if you plan on doing like a revival category or something like this, this is definitely not going to be the banner for you. I will say, though, that these units are really good for their respective teams. They're really cool. The Kaba is farmable. It's a pain in the butt to farm him, but you can farm him if you want to. Hit is not farmable. So, I mean, whatever. You can't really do anything about that at this point in time. But yeah, they're both really cool units. I would recommend pulling on it if you plan on doing the mono teams. Outside of that, I guess the only other thing that may work is, like, if you were to do like a hybrid Saiyan team, even though Kaba wouldn't get the boost for being a hybrid Saiyan, Gohan does do that boost for strength units, so you could throw him on there and you could throw a couple hybrid Saiyans in that team on top of your strength units to make the team really OP. At that point, it would be really kind of a little bit worth it. The other two cards we're going to talk about is the two Gotenks. Now, I said this before when the event came out in the Yo Son Goku and his friends return event. You have the Gotenks base forms, the strength and the agility. They both now get their Dokkan Awakenings. That is because the Super Saiyan 3 Gotenks event is coming out in 2 days, guys. So we have that information. Get the Gotenks. I do not recommend, if you have them, to Dokkan Awaken them unless you grinded out that event and got it up to get them up to Super Attack 10. Honestly, that's my honest opinion. I don't recommend doing that. At some point, get them up to Super Tech 10, then Dokken Awakening them. The strength one's really good. Honestly, I'm not going to lie to you. I like the strength one. Attack plus 77% just for being there, and an additional 23% for being first attacker in turn. On top of that, after he attacks, he gives an additional 20% for everyone. That's a very viable skill. He does have Fierce Battle. He has Fuse Fighter, Shocking Speed, Kamehameha, the Saiyan Lineage, Saiyan Warrior Race, and the Innocence. He has a really good Link skill set. So honestly, for a mono strength team, he'd be very good. For a Fusions team, he'd be pretty decent as well. But for a Fusions team, honestly, you're probably not going to want to consider running him if you have the OP units. This unit over here, I'm not a huge fan of, but he does increase, his passive skill does increase based off of key orb obtained, and it's just any key orb, so on average you're getting about five and a half, something like that, which is, works out to be about 75% attack buff, so it's not horrible. I don't recommend running him though, unless you don't have anyone else. He is still a decent unit. He also does have Fierce Battle, which makes him a little bit better. He also does key for all types, plus 3, attack and defense, plus 30%, so for brand new players, he may be a little bit more viable for you. Though, if you are a brand new player, trying to get the medals from the actual Gotenks vendor are going to be in the pain in the butt. Now, the last card we're going to talk about is a Super Saiyan 3 Gotenks, which is going to be available in 2 more days with all this stuff that's coming. Well, at least the other Gotenks are going to be available. This guy's phenomenal. I highly recommend pulling on him. I don't know what's going to be on the banner as of yet, but when we get that information, I'll talk about it. I'll talk about the banner, the viability of the banner, and if you guys should pull on it or not. Honestly, I'm going to tell you right now. Super Saiyan 3 Gotenks is probably going to be one of the most versatile units in-game in the foreseeable future for at least the next 4 to 6 months. That is because he is available for 4 of the category teams, 4 of the major category teams. He's available on Hybrid Saiyan, he's available on Super Saiyan 3, he's available on the Fusions team, he's available for the Majin Buu arc team. This guy is awesome and he hits so hard. Now granted, you can say, you know, there's some arguments, oh well, the Tech one is just as good, it's just he doesn't hit as hard. You know, you can get through any event with the Tech 1. That's true. I do have my Tech 1 100%ed. But because they didn't do the Vegito Blue, the physical one, on the banner, on last banner, I think he's going to be on this banner because, A, physical unit, he's a super physical unit, and it kind of coincides with the hype of Vegito Blue. So it's up to you on how you guys want to approach that. I would recommend pulling on it when it becomes available, but I will be doing a full banner review once it becomes available. Hopefully it'll come out in the next day or two so that way we can talk about it. If not, I'll give you guys a video on Sunday night after I get out of work, so that way we can go and talk about it after it's gotten released. But that's it, guys. That's all the information. One thing I did want to say, the Supreme Kai Trials, if any of you are wondering about it, it actually comes from, now this is for the Vegito Blue, it's the Supreme Kai Trials that are going to be available underneath the Missions tab, and these are the things that you're looking to get. So these are the ones that you want to get in order to buy the Vegito, the base form Vegito that will Dokken Awaken to the Vegito Blue. But yeah, guys, outside of that, that's it. That's all I have to talk about for you with you today. I will keep you posted on the news and all other information that comes to the global side and the JP side, so make sure to subscribe. And I'll catch you all in the comments below. Peace.